Hello, this is my final journal reflection assignment. The three concepts that I wanted to go over are from chapter 8, 10, and 12. The concept from chapter 8 that I wanted to discuss is face saving, which the definition that textbook gives us is the preservation of a person's dignity may involve giving indirect answers to avoid hurting or embarrassing another person. This is a really common thing that happens in a lot of Asian households where we save face all the time. My mom is constantly telling me saving face. You know, it's like, come on, I'm doing what's best for the situation here. I think my mom is the one who usually is the one that does the face saving. My dad is more quiet and reserved, while my mom is more extroverted. So in this case, it's usually my mom who's always saying like, see, I did this so that I could save face. And that, like, her way of saying it is that it makes her seem like the better person in the situation. Instead of making things worse, she decided to take the upper hand and just kind of save face and save the situation. When we're in public, sometimes my mom will try to save face. I don't really know exactly from what. We don't really need our faces to be saved. That's not the actual expression here, but she likes to take it one step further from what the situation actually is. I find that really interesting because she's always throwing the word face saving, you know, or saving face, face saving, all that. The concept from chapter 10 is values, and the definition is one's ideas about what is important in life. Everyone should have values, and, you know, we as humans have human values where we have to be considerate, you know, empathetic, we have openness, we consider other people, we respect, acceptance, all of that. And sometimes people just don't have that concept. Something that's really valuable to me is when people respect service workers, people who work at restaurants, cashiers, all these workers, okay? People who are actually serving us, right? These ideals, I guess, in a way, and these values that we have for us are all individualistic. Like, everyone, not everyone has the same values. We might have similar values, but not everyone has the exact same values, unless maybe it's from parent to child, and that child really is taking in those values from their parents really seriously, then sure, they'll inherit all of their same values because they see life in the same way. And a lot of the times, our parents will take their values and teach it to us, their children. It's up to us to look at the perspective of what they're seeing is important as a value. And we determine if we want to keep that or just look for something else in life that we find is equally as important. One concept from chapter 12 is interpersonal synchrony. The exhibition of similarities, the interpersonal fusion of two individuals. I think the similarities to me would be personality-wise, right? Not everyone has the same personality. There's a lot of people with introverted, extroverted, ambiverted, people who are socially awkward or, you know, socially accepting of everyone, all of that, all those things. And with this, it kind of shows who we are, right? When you're around one group of people, you act a certain way. When you're around another group of people, you act a different way. And that kind of shows synchrony, but it's not really between two people. It's within like a group of people. And usually we have a pretty tight-knit group of friends that we call our really close friends. And with the interpersonal fusion of two individuals, this is kind of like, maybe I can go into the example of relationship wise. Most times we find people who are opposite of us because it's really, really intriguing to learn about someone who's different from you. That's probably why you got into a relationship. And maybe, you know, of course, you like them for their personality, their characteristics, their values. And most times with this interpersonal synchrony fusion, you know, between two individuals, this is through growth and, like, you find yourself liking the same thing that they like before even really talking about it. That's kind of how that works. And like in the dating world, you know, people get pretty bored easily nowadays. I mean, I haven't really experienced anything like that yet, but people are like, ugh, you know, you're not exciting, right? Maybe you're too similar. If you're too similar, then you like too much of the same things, and then you get bored of that because you already do that in your own time and you want to do something more exciting with somebody else. And if they're too similar to you, then it's too synchronous, right? Which kind of is, it's too familiar. Something that I did not know before the course was that there was an interpersonal communications class. I really thought there was only public speaking, and I honestly don't really care about public speaking because I don't need to talk to too many people. And even if I did, I guess I could get a better understanding of that through interpersonal communication, because it's mainly between one to two people, a smaller group of people, but mainly another person. And I found that when I found this class, I was like, oh, that's pretty good. And even in the summer, right? Because I don't like talking that much, because I have been talking a lot now. I found this class to be pretty useful, and also I learned a few new things about these theories, and like, oh, aha, that's where that came from in my life. And like, before, I didn't know where this concept came from, and through this class, I was able to learn where these concepts of how we humans interact with each other and how we take on the role of another person sometimes. The people you're always with are you, but just a different person. This class has been really helpful. I really thought we were going to learn how to say less in this class, but we didn't even go over that at all in this class, because I know that saying filler words in general is not frowned upon, but shouldn't be done as much. I believe that I did meet my goal for this class, even though some things haven't been graded yet. And I said that I wanted to keep straight A's in all my classes, and yeah, I have straight A's in all my classes, which is really good for me. I took three classes this summer, and this was one of them. And all my classes have reading or writing, so I kind of was able to take stuff from this class and integrate it with my sociology class as well as my English class, which is pretty cool. I haven't gotten my permit yet. I will soon, maybe after this class, maybe after I finish all my classes on Thursday, I will start prepping for that. One tip that I would give to a future student taking this class is to keep in mind that making captions is not the end of the world. At first, it was really annoying to do captions because it's just typing up the words. I have to pause every few seconds, but I was like, you know what? We really should be typing up captions. I never really took into full consideration that there are hearing impaired people who also watch stuff online. How could I be so inconsiderate? I did hear that other students were complaining about writing captions, and I thought it's really not that big of a deal. You know, same I was getting a little bit annoyed with writing captions, but it really is just the smallest thing, and it really does help people who are hearing impaired. Just someone who has a disability, and you know, it's easier for them to understand because they're human too. So don't get annoyed with making videos. Making videos is the easiest thing that you can do. You have to just press a button and then boom, you can make a video. And making captions, sometimes it's auto-generated, so you don't have to worry about that. But typing it up is also not that big of a deal. Just say fewer words, so there you go. I did enjoy my experience in this course. In the class survey, I also said the same thing where I wish that I had unmuted faster so that I could respond to stuff, because I was actually more confident in answering questions and stuff like that. I do notice that a lot of my other classes, when teachers are like, so class, you know, what's going on? Anyone have any opinions about anything? People are just like kind of timid and just not wanting to say anything. Or maybe they're just tired. But for me, I wish that I had unmuted faster and that I would have been able to answer questions more, because I did want to start a conversation with teachers. I did want the teacher to know that I was paying attention and that I was capable of engaging with him, her, them in conversation, even if it was just between the teacher and me. I had a really good time learning in this course, so that's pretty good. Thank you for watching my video, and thank you for a wonderful semester in your interpersonal communications class. I hope your future students are just as cool as I am. Just kidding, they will be.